Welcome friends, in previous lecture we see definitions on graphs. Now one more definition, simple graph. A graph is said to be simple if it has no loops and no parallel edges. A graph is said to be simple if it has no loops and no parallel edges. For example, here, this is simple graph of three vertices and three edges like this. Another, this is also simple graph. Now one more definition, isomorphism. A graph G1 V1 E1 is said to be isomorphic to a graph G2 with vertex set V2 and a set E2 if there is 1-1 correspondence, 1-1 correspondence between vertex sets V1 and V2 and A sets E1 and E2 in such a way that if E1 is an edge width, E1 is an edge width and vertices U1 and V1 in G1, then the corresponding edge E2 with n vertices U2 and V2 in G2 which correspond to U1 and V1 respectively. That means these two graphs, G1 and G2, is said to be isomorphic if there is 1-1 correspondence between vertex sets and edge sets. If E1 is an edge in G1 with end vertices, U1, V1 in G1, its corresponding edge E2 in G2 with end vertices U2, V2, then U2, V2 also corresponds with U1, V1. Then these two graphs said to be isomorphic. See here, some examples here. Here, graph with four vertex. V1, V2, V3, V4. Edges E1, E2, E3, E4 and E5. Now, here see these two graphs, four vertices, V1, V2, V3, V4. Here this edge is E1, E2, E3 or E4 and this is E5. There is one correspondence between these two graphs. Now see here another example. If you take here V1, V2, V3, V4, V5. Now, this is also graph with 5 vertices and 5 edges. Now here one corresponds like this here. If you start from here, V1, one corresponds. Now V2, this is V3, here V4 and V5, like this. This is isomorphic. If one correspondence like this. Now another example here. If you take vertex name, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then see here, starting from, suppose this is 1, 2, and this is 3. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, like this. Then, these are one correspondence. So, these two graphs are isomorphic. These two graphs are isomorphic. Now, see here. another example. Graph on 6 vertex. U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, U6, and another graph. If we take here this V1, V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. Here U1, U2, V3. Here U1 corresponds to CR V1, U2 corresponds to CR, U1 corresponds to V1, okay? Then U2 corresponds to V3. U3 corresponds to V5. Now U4 corresponds to V2. U5 corresponds to V4. And U6 correspond to V6. This correspondence, and so these two graphs are isomorphic. These two graphs are isomorphic. Now, if two graphs are isomorphic, then the number of the same number of vertices, first case, both graphs the same number of vertices, and second, the same number of edges. If two graphs are isomorphic to each other, then number of vertices and number of edges same in both graphs. But this condition is not sufficient. That means if number of vertices and number of edges are same, but given graphs are not isomorphic. For example, see here these two graphs. Here 6 vertices, here also 6 vertices, number of edges they are 9. Here also 9 edges. But these two graphs are not isomorphic because there is no one-to-one correspondence between this vertex set and S set. Now, one more definition. A complete graph is a simple graph in which each pair of distinct vertices is joined by an edge. That means each pair in this graph adjacent. A complete graph is a simple graph in which each pair distinct vertices is joined by an edge. That means every pair is adjacent. Some examples here. If you take this is complete graph. Now, if you take this is not a complete. Why it is not a complete? See here, these two vertices not adjacent. Also, these two vertices, now if we join these two, then it is complete graph. And complete graph of n vertices is denoted by kn. Complete graph of n vertices is denoted by kn. Here, G is complete graph. With n vertices v1, v2, vn, then the H set can be given E is equal to VIVJ such that VIVI is not equal to VJ for IJ is equal to 1, 2 up to N. In complete graph, each vertex incident with n minus 1 edges. Complete graph. In complete graph, each vertex incident with n minus 1 edges. So, n, there are n into n minus 1 by divided 2 edges, total edges. Because this counts vi, vj is equal to vj vi. That means s from vi to vj is same as s from vj to vi. So this count double. So total number of edges in a complete graph is n into n minus 1 by 2. That means k 10 has how many edges? 10 into 9 by 2, 45 edges. Now, bipartite graph. First, an EMT graph or an EMT or trivial graph is a graph which has no edges, In subtext, it is also called null graph. That means graph with vertex, but no edges. Now, bipartite graph. Let GVA graph if vertex set of G partition into two sets X and Y. That means V is equal to X union Y and X intersection Y is equal to phi. Partition of V such as X union Y is equal to V and X intersection Y is equal to V in such a way that each edge of G has one end in X, and one end in Y. Then G is called bipartite graph. That means vertex set of G can be partitioned into two vertex sets, X and Y. V is equal to X union Y and X intersection Y is equal to phi in such way that each edge of G has a one end in X and one end in Y. This graph is bipartite graph. Yes, here U1, U2, U3, U4, U5, V, U6. Here, X is the set U1, U2, U3 and Y is the set U4, U5, U6. Like this. Complete. Here, there is no common element in between X and Y, and union of this is equal to vertex set. And see here, each edge, this edge, one end is in X, other end in Y. Now see this edge, one end in X and other end in Y. And so this is a bipartite graph. This is not isomorphic. This is not a bipartite graph. Now, a complete bipartite graph. In complete bipartite graph, in a bipartite graph, is a simple bipartite graph in which every vertex in X is joined to every vertex Y. That means complete bipartite graph is a simple bipartite graph. A simple bipartite graph means there is no loop and no parallel edges. Simple bipartite graph. Graph with bipartition V is equal to X union Y, in which every vertex in X is joined to every vertex of Y. If X has M vertices and Y has N vertices, then complete bipartite graph is denoted by KMN. KMN. That means K for complete and M for one number of vertices in one set and N is number of vertices in other set. See here, if you take this example, this is not a complete bipartite graph because this vertex joined with only two vertex, not here. If you take this, this is also not a complete bipartite graph. If you take join this with and, then this is complete bipartite graph. Complete bipartite graph. Now this star graph is called star graph. If you take here total vertices 6, but if you take partition X, this is V1, then V2, V3, V4, V5, V6. X is equal to only V1 and Y is equal to V2, V3 up to V6. It contains one vertex, it contains Y contains 5 vertex. Then this is K15, and this is also called star graph. This is also called star graph. That means K1N is called star graph with N plus 1 vertices. With N plus 1 vertices. Okay. We stop here. Thank you.